The GR86 is already a favorite among sports car enthusiasts, but this is the 2023 10th anniversary special edition. In this episode, we're going to have a look at what makes this so special and whether you should buy it. What's it like? Buckle up and let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racing driver, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, the 86 and BRZ have been with us for a couple of years, but this 86 is now celebrating its 10th anniversary with this special edition. And I suppose any reason is a good reason to drive a GR86. And before we get into what this is like to drive, let's have a look at this GR86 10th anniversary special edition in a little more depth. We've already driven the new GR86 and the BRZ for what that's worth, but it's worth discussing the differences between this all-new GR86 and the previous one. For starters, there's a much stiffer chassis, and then after that, we've got a bigger engine. It's still a flat 4, but now it's a 2.4 liter, and that results in a nice bump in power, makes 228 horsepower at 7,000 RPM, and 184 pounds of torque at 3,400 RPM. Transmission choices are a 6-speed manual or a 6-speed automatic, and I've never driven an automatic 86. They've done it right with a mechanical limited slip diff in the back, McPherson struts at the front, a double wishbone style multi-link rear suspension setup, conventional dampers, no adaptive type, brakes are 11.6 inch rotors at the front, 11.4 at the rear, single piston calipers. This one is rocking 18s, and these 18s are actually forged because this is the 10th anniversary special edition. Tires are Michelin Pilot Sport 4s, which are just lovely on this thing. And because this is the 10th anniversary model, it gets the solar shift paint, a cat back exhaust, these stripes, and the interior is ultra suede and leather. And of course, there's lots of custom orange trim in the interior of this 86 10th anniversary. Curb weight of this GR86 with the manual is about 2,800 pounds, and static weight distribution is about 53% front, 47% rear. But on this channel, we know it's not static weight distribution that counts, it's how you use it. Fundamentally, the only difference inside the cabin of this 10th anniversary model is the trim, the upholstery, and a little bit of orange, which actually adds a very cool touch. The orange is distinctive and it really changes the vibe inside the cabin. After that, this is standard 86 and I can't complain. The interface to the 86 is perfect for me. Great relationship to the pedals and to the steering wheel. The steering wheel is shaped perfectly. Great amount of adjustment. I'm absolutely seated perfectly here in this 86. Sure, I could go lower, but I'm really not going to complain too much about that. After that, great relationship to the shifter, and the ergonomics, first and second level ergonomics, are traditional GR86 or BRZ. The infotainment system is saved by the fact that it's got Apple CarPlay. Otherwise, there's not much to write home about here. It looks like it could come from the aftermarket. Really not sure where this comes from. Maybe Subaru? Not quite sure, but it's a simple, simple system. And when you are running it on CarPlay, it works fantastically. Very happy with it. Now, in terms of storage, you know the deal. This is a GR86. There's a little bit of room in the trunk. The seat does fold down flat. It's a single piece, not a split folding seat, mind you. And there's a little bit of storage inside this cabin. If you wanted to live with this 86 on a day-to-day basis and didn't have a small family to cart around, absolutely you can do that. It works on a day-to-day basis. It's the right size as well. You can park it pretty much anywhere. This is just quick enough, and it is incredibly responsive, and that's really the name of the game here with the GR86, but it's quick enough. At 0 to 60 is probably touch under 6 seconds, not quite sure, but it's more than quick enough. Lots of traction, at least in a straight line, with these Michelin tires, and overall, I have no complaints about acceleration. It is quick enough to keep up with almost everything in regular traffic, and then when you want to have fun, fun with it, well, its responsiveness kind of trumps everything else. Compared to the previous generation, the larger engine here helps out a lot. It's changed the torque curve dramatically, and it's rewarding also to rev all the way to redline because it makes peak power way up at the top. So it's a lot of fun to really just run this through the gears because it makes more power up at the top and has a decent amount of torque for day-to-day driving. The limited slip diff in the back is just magic, and it helps with overall balance of this 86, which we will talk about in a little bit. Just works flawlessly. The suspension is dialed, which we will get into, but that limited slip diff is part of this overall package, this refined sports car package that makes it work so well. Another highlight of this GR86 is this manual shifter. It just feels great, does exactly what you want it to do. The ratios are perfectly spaced. It's like they were carefully considered. It's just a great all-around gearbox, and the way the shifter works is perfect. Decent weight out of the shifter, great feel and weight from the clutch as well. I really cannot complain about this manual transmission at all. I should talk about this exhaust, and yes, it is loud. There's a bit more drone here than in a regular 86, and when you start this up, it is loud. There's a lot of low frequency sound coming out of this thing, and it probably rattled the windows of my neighbors' houses. I think they weren't happy that I would start this up very early in the morning, but regardless, it is noisier. It does drown out some of the sound system. The sound system here, really not great either. You really need some better speakers and a little bit more power, at least for my race car addled ears. I'd like some clarity out of the sound system and a little bit more power so I could hear the sound system a little bit better. On one hand, I do love the sound that this cat-back exhaust makes, and on the other hand, on longer drives, it does get a little grating. The other highlight about this GR86 with the manual gearbox is how easy it is to heel and toe. This is just perfection. Ah, yes. And if you don't know what heel and toe is, links here, links below. We've got a whole episode on it on this channel. If you drive a manual transmission car, you definitely need to know how to heel and toe. Seriously, the reasons why it's so easy to heel and toe this thing is because the throttle response is spot on, and then you've got great feel out of the shifter as well as the clutch. In terms of a vehicle being an extension of the driver, this does everything I want it to do as a driver. And if you are someone who's looking to improve their skills, maybe take this to the track, figure out the whole performance on-track driving thing, maybe learn how to heel and toe, this is an incredible teacher. Ah, yeah, putting down power, no problem. And a little more heel and toe, just for fun. So easy, back on the throttle. Ah, yeah, so good. And not that we need to, but another heel and toe. So good, flawless. In terms of handling, the thing about this 86 is that it is a well-rounded, refined package, and everything works in harmony all together. And if something was out of harmony or out of balance, it wouldn't be as satisfying a package as it is. This is just incredibly satisfying to drive, and it does exactly what I want it to do, when I want it to do, with precision. There's a lot to be said about the tire. The Michelin Pilot Sport 4 is a decent all-around tire. It's not a sticky track tire, so it doesn't have incredibly high limits, nor are these tires very wide. So you still have that great balance that all 86s are known for. Not a tremendous amount of grip, and then what that means is you can communicate and play with this at its limit. So not only can you tell it what to do, but it's going to respond and tell you what it's doing. Feedback is incredible, and that's in every way. Through the steering wheel, through the brake pedal, and through the chassis, that feedback is high fidelity, and there is never any question in the driver's mind what's going on with this 86 anywhere near its limits. It really does talk to you, and talks to you in the right way. That's the thing. Steering response absolutely spot on, combined with the suspension setup here. There's not a lot of body roll. It's actually at a reasonable minimum. And once you get into a corner, you turn in, it just eases its way in. It's very, very happy, talks to you throughout the corner. And then if you're playing with it at its limits, you can really find the limit with your inputs as well as dance with this around its limits. It's incredibly responsive and it tells you what it's doing. Exiting a corner, lean into the throttle, get a little bit of oversteer, and the 86 says, hey, we're getting a little bit of slip angle at the rear axle. What do you want to do about it? And you think about it for a second and you say, well, I want to continue that. Lean into the throttle, countersteer, no problem whatsoever. If you want to tidy your line, well, you just breathe off the throttle a little bit and that line tightens right up. This is just incredibly responsive. And now that I've put so many, many miles or kilometers on these new 86s, this is just a complete extension of me. Braking is perfection here. I know exactly what's going on when I'm on that brake pedal. And on top of that, brakes are powerful. I actually had to avoid an SUV. I don't know what they were doing. Maybe they were busy on Facebook on their phone, but pulled out in front of me, had to engage full ABS and no problem getting this thing slowed down to avoid mindless SUV drivers. The thing about the forged wheels on this 10th anniversary special edition is that they are lighter than the standard wheel. What that allows the dampers to do is to control those wheels a little bit better simply because they weigh less, and that is very much a good thing. I wouldn't have complained about body and wheel control in the non-10th anniversary GR86. Body and wheel control is impeccable, and I can't complain. Anytime I've been enjoying this in the corners, it communicates so clearly. There's no mistaking what's going on with this 86 at any point in the corner. It's just an unbelievably communicative car, and we're very, very fortunate that Toyota still makes this in 2023. It's a very special car. How do you spec yours? Well, this is fairly easy and it's going to be a quick one. As tested, this is $36,360 in the US and Canada. It's $39,950. And the only option you can get on your 10th anniversary special edition GR86 is an automatic transmission. Do we want that? No, no, we don't. So this is how you spec your GR86 10th anniversary special edition. My verdict? Well, we often talk about fuel consumption at this point in the episode, and given that this is somewhat of an economical sports car, we will talk about fuel consumption, and I'm getting about 25 miles per gallon in mixed driving, and that's without even trying. Regular viewers of the show know I love to use the throttle pedal, and this still is returning about 25 miles per gallon. As for this 10th anniversary model being a good value, well, there are a couple of considerations that we need to get into. Those considerations have to do with how much you're going to spend to get this 10th anniversary model and its features. This is about $3,400 more in the United States over a premium model, about $5,500 Canadian over the premium model. And the question is there value in this special paint, the interior trim? But forged wheels, absolutely, thumbs up on those. This exhaust, well, it's incredibly loud, especially on startup, and I did annoy my neighbors with this exhaust system. Not that I really care, but it is very loud, especially on startup. And even on the highway, it's still on the loud side. That said, if you are an 86 enthusiast, you probably have no choice but to get this. If you're like me, you probably will be happy with a black 86, some lightweight wheels, and call it a day. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2023 Toyota GR86 10th anniversary special edition. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, well, you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring, so please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even Toyota GR86s.